Hi, I'm Gordon from Camera Labs, and this is the Powershot G1X Mark III, Canon's new flagship premium compact camera. The G1X Mark III looks almost identical to the G5X seen here on the right, but it boasts a much larger APS-C sensor. That's got almost 3 times the surface area of the 1-inch sensors found in most premium compacts like the G5X. In fact, it's the same sensor used in DSLRs like the EOS 80D with 24 megapixels and Canon's dual pixel CMOS AF. This allows it to confidently refocus during movies and also track action for stills at 7 frames per second. The built-in lens has a 3x zoom equivalent to 24-72mm with an f2.8 to 5.6 focal ratio. It also has a built-in 3-stop neutral density filter. Startup time is about 2 seconds, but you'll need to remove and replace the lens cap by hand. If you're interested in the potential for a shallow depth of field, here's a shot I took with a pre-production model at 24mm f2.8 from the closest focusing distance at wide angle of 10 centimeters. And now here's one I took at 72mm f5.6 from the telephoto closest focusing distance of 30cm. As you'd expect, the potential for blurring is roughly similar to the results you'd get with a DSLR or mirrorless kit zoom. But of course the big difference is that you can change those lenses on a DSLR or mirrorless camera for one that delivers shallower depth of field effects if you like. Whereas on the G1X Mark III, like other premium compacts, that lens is fixed in place. In a big upgrade over the previous G1X Mark II, you get to compose with either a built-in OLED viewfinder, it's roughly the same size as the image you get on the G5X, or a fully articulated touchscreen that can flip out at any angle, including facing the subject. If you recall, on the earlier G1X Mark II, the screen only tilted vertically and the viewfinder was an optional accessory. Moving on to the controls, the lens has a smooth ring around it that doesn't click as you turn. On the front surface, there's a vertically mounted finger dial, which works in the same way as the G5X. It gives very tactile clicked feedback as you turn it. On the top right surface, you'll find a dedicated exposure compensation dial. And turning to the rear of the camera, you'll find a small thumb wheel. So all in all, there's plenty of control options on the G1X Mark III. The main mode dial on the upper left side now has a locking button preventing it from turning by accident, and the G1X Mark III also becomes the first Canon camera to offer a panorama mode that can stitch images in camera. Unbelievably, this wasn't available on earlier models. Around the side there's HDMI and USB ports, and the latter can be used to charge the battery in camera. There's also a jack for an optional remote cord, but sadly no microphone input. Now I think that's a real missed opportunity for videographers and vloggers who'd otherwise love the Mark III for its big sensor, flip out screen and fantastic movie autofocus. On the upside, there's Wi-Fi built in, complemented by NFC and Bluetooth. Bluetooth maintains a low power link with your smartphone for seamless location tagging and also easy reconnections to the Wi-Fi for remote control and image transfer. The grip is small but surprisingly comfortable in your hands, and the body itself impressively is one of the only compacts around that boasts weather sealing. Classy move, Canon. Wrapping up, you won't be surprised to learn that there's no 4K video. After all, it's a Canon camera, right? And as you already know, no microphone input, nor an automatic lens cap either. Inevitably, thanks to that big sensor, it's also one of the most expensive compacts to date. But equally, there's no denying the appeal of squeezing the photo and movie quality of models like the EOS 80D into a compact, weatherproof body that weighs less than 400 grams. I reckon it's one of Canon's most compelling cameras for quite a while, and it looks set to be as popular as a standalone camera as it will as a companion to larger DSLRs. Right, that's it for now. If you like my videos, please don't forget to subscribe, and if you'd like more information on this, or indeed any other camera, please check out my in-depth articles at CameraLabs.com. Thanks for watching, bye!